I guess you've heard of stem cell therapy, right? Those very expensive injections you can get of stem cells into your damaged tissues or damaged organs that will help to repair and rebuild the damage. What if I told you you have about 700,000 stem cells of your own in your body right now that could be doing that job for you? Welcome to Shape Fixer. I'm Andrew Tunstall. I'm your nutrition and lifestyle coach. And I'm going to talk to you a bit more about stem cells and the latest research and the latest knowledge that we have. Now, stem cells, we started off as stem cells, embryonic stem cells that gave rise to every single type of cell in our body, liver cells, bone cells, muscle cells, all of them started off as stem cells, which is really just a cell that is got all your DNA, but it hasn't differentiated into any particular type of tissue cell yet. We do have a whole lot of them, as I said, about 700,000 still in our bodies. Most seems to be in the bone marrow, but there are numbers of them in other organs around our body. Now, 700,000 might sound like a lot, but there are a lot of cells in your body. And 700,000 means you have about one stem cell for every 45 million cells in your body. So they're quite rare, I guess, and they're not always easy to find, which is why scientists are still finding places in our body where they're hiding out. And it's really, really exciting. Now, these cells are called adult stem cells as opposed to embryonic stem cells. They're sometimes called somatic stem cells, but never mind about that. So these adult stem cells that are packed around strategic parts of our body must be doing something. And we've known for a while that the ones in the bone marrow can grow new bone cells, or they can grow new red blood cells. But it has more recently been found that they can also produce liver cells, lung cells, and skin cells. And that's what we know so far. But in addition to that knowledge, we also now have more knowledge about stem cells that are found in the brain and in the muscles and in the lungs. And we're finding them in new places all the time. So the assumption has got to be that if that's where they are, then that's where they're working and that's what they're producing. So it's really, really important to understand that we need these stem cells and we need them to be doing what they're doing. They regenerate us all the time. We grow new skin all the time. We grow new hair all the time. Our hair falls out and it grows back. So all that is to do with our stem cells. When we don't look after our bodies, we damage our stem cells. And when we damage our stem cells, we suffer from things like hair loss, kidney disease, cancer, diabetes, dementia. Now, it's not to say that those things won't happen even if you do have healthy stem cells, but with damaged stem cells, those problems are more likely and they are worse, and it's harder for us to combat them or fight against them. So what damages our stem cells? Well, firstly, age generally. Unfortunately, as we get older, they become slightly less functional, which makes it all the more important to look after them as we age. Tobacco absolutely destroys our stem cells, so we shouldn't be smoking. Alcohol in high amounts is really damaging to our stem cells, so we should drink in moderation. Inflammation generally impairs the functioning of our stem cells, and I've done a video on inflammation. I'll put a link down here in the video description, how you can keep your inflammation in check by eating properly. High blood sugar damages your stem cells. High blood sugar that leads to diabetes. Once you're diabetic, your stem cells are a disaster. So we really need to control our sugar intake. And of course, as we know, sugar means carbohydrates, starches. Those are, of course, all made of sugar. So what do? We want healthy stem cells. We want to be able to repair and rebuild. What do? Well, there are things we stop doing, and there are things we need to do more of. The things we need to stop doing are abusing alcohol, smoking tobacco, eating sugar, or carbohydrates. All of those three things, those are the three really bad culprits. We need, by doing that, to lower our inflammation. So if we have lower inflammation, our stem cells will work better. We need to get our stress levels down, which is not always easy, but there are ways to manage stress. Getting better sleep is one way. Getting more exercise is another way. And we need to reduce our weight. So if we're overweight, particularly obese, we are heading for diabetes and heart disease and inflammation and all sorts of other problems. And we need to get our weight back down through sensible diet and sensible exercise. Okay, so what do we do? What did I say? We sleep. We work on our sleep. I've done a video on sleep. Watch the video on sleep. We start getting regular exercise. It doesn't have to be hectic, crazy exercise. Just light, regular exercise. We need to be fasting, in other words, not eating all the time. And we've done videos on fasting and autophagy. And you need ideally 16 hours between your dinner and your first meal of the next day. It's not all that difficult to get 16 hours. That will get your inflammation down and will get your repair systems running better. You need to drink more tea. Green tea, black tea, any tea. Tea is very good for your stem cells. And you know what else is really good for your stem cells? Is dark chocolate. At least 73% cocoa. Make sure it's not spiked with sugar. The chocolate companies can be a bit sneaky with that. So just check the back of the packet to make sure it hasn't got a high sugar content. And a combination of exercise, sleep, proper food, cutting out sugar, cutting out smoking, getting better sleep, will enhance your stem cells and their ability to repair and build and regrow where you are damaged and where age is just taking its toll on you. And it's a much easier and a much cheaper way of doing it than spending $5,000 on a stem cell injection. So there you go. Take care of your stem cells so they take care of you. Thank you for watching. Please click a like on this video and subscribe to our channel.